Yes, first question. In the set 2, Belgium solved its problem successfully by
power saving.
What is the answer?
Developing
the power sharing mechanism, rejecting the policy of majoritarianism, respecting the interest of different communities, all the above. What is the answer? I'll come to that.
All the above.
Can you read it? Answer is given there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
All the above. Okay. Because first I, before I finalize the question paper, I have written the answer also there. Because there should be no confusion in the answer key. That is why I have written the answer. Okay, second question. Which of the statement is an example of horizontal sharing of power? Tell me.
Executive judiciary and
horizontal share power sharing.
Different organ of
power. Sir, it is not
visible clearly, sir. Can you?
Yes, sir. It is not visible.
No.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you tell
option
me?
A, sir.
Power sharing between different organs of the government. Very good. Next one. Identify the distinguishing feature of the federal system. Power is distributed among the legislature, executive and judiciary. Is it a federal system? What happened?
No, sir.
What happened? How the computer, this has gone out? Where am I? Okay. Identify the distinguishing features of the federal system. Elected officials exercise supreme power in the government. Is it a federal system? No. The national government gives some power to the provincial government. Is it a federal system?
No, sir.
So, government power is divided between different levels of the government. Is it a federal system?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Government power is divided between different levels of government. That is a correct answer of a federal system. Okay.
Sir, what is difference between levels and organs?
Levels, central government, state government, there's a level, upper level, lower level. Organ is part of the main body. That is legislative, executive, and judicial. They are called organs. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Executive, judiciary, and legislature, they are called organs. They are equal, horizontal. Okay, all the three have got equal powers and all the three have got checks and balances. That is called a horizontal power. One cannot claim I am supreme, I am lower, no. But in the levels, top level is there, bottom level is there. It is a vertical power sharing. Central top is a state, central government. Central government is having for all. So it is a vertical from top to bottom. It is like a pyramid. Pyramidical structure it is going up. That is known as vertical power sharing. Downside, so many panchayats are there. We have got so many districts, no? Understand?
Yes, sir.
We have got so many districts, but we don't have so many states. Lesser number of states than the districts. Okay, then lesser number of country, only one country is there. So, it is a pyramidical structure. On the top, it comes as a point. Then it comes down. that is known as a vertical power sharing. Central government, state government and village panchayat in India. So that is known
local
as a pardon?
Local government, sir.
Local government and village panchayat. So it is called a vertical power sharing. From top to bottom. Bottom will be, there will be multiple groups of people to share the power. At the top, there will be one group. That is only the national parliament, national government. And national government, when it comes, it is divided into three organs. Legislature, executive and judiciary. That is known as a horizontal power sharing. Equal, both sides. Okay. Which of the following aspect signifies the image of Germania? Austerity and asceticism. What is austerity and asceticism? Means sitting and meditating. Sages' behavior is called asceticism. Sacrificing everything and sitting. Meditating. Giving everything to others. That is austerity and asceticism. Second point is heroism and justice. Is she providing justice to anybody? That statue of Germany has fallen down. You have seen. Will that statue provide justice to anybody? Hello? Nobody is there in the screen? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
By then, why are you not answering?
What is question, sir?
I'll come to down. Some of you just come, I'll unlock it. Yes. Unlock the room.
Sir, can you send the question paper in WhatsApp group, sir?
This one? Now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me see. I will scan it and photo, take the photo and send. Okay. But the answer key also is there, no problem. I have not printed our one, otherwise I would have given the original one. Did you get? Thank you. Good morning, sir. Okay, you can correct. You got it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, question number. You are discussing about the question number fourth one. Okay, question number fifth. What emphasizes the notion of united community enjoying equal rights under a constitution? What is the answer? The fatherland. Okay. Can you hear me? Boys?
Yes, sir.
So, ready? Now we will come to the sixth question. Each power, Russia, Germany, England, Austro-Hungary was keen on countering the hold of the other powers over the Balkans. This has become one of the major reasons for First World War, Second World War, fall of the Ottoman Empire, integration of the Balkan states.
First World War.
Yes. Did the Balkan state...
First World War, sir.
Yes. Answer is First World. Did the Balkan state integrate itself?
No, sir.
No. They were disunited, they were broken up into different pieces.
Yes.
And fall of the Ottoman Empire is not before the First World War. It has happened after the First World War. Okay.
Yes.
Second World War started in which year?
1939 started, sir. 1945 ended.
So, Second World War, 1939. So, this is... Before 1939, First World War was from 1914 to 1918. So
yes,
the answer
sir.
Is First World War. Okay. Next one. A belief that the majority community should be able to rule the country in whichever way it wants. By disregarding the wishes and needs of the minority is called a...
Majority.
Your answer is gone wrong there. It is a majoritarianism. Okay?
Yes, sir. Option C, sir.
Option C is answer that. Okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, majority, whatever the majority tells, others should listen. That is the meaning of it. That is the intention of that sentence. Next one. Which one of the following statements about power sharing arrangement is correct? Power sharing is
that
necessary.
Sir, every society needs some form of power sharing.
Yes. Every society needs some form of power sharing, even if it is small or does not have a social divisions. Even individual,
yes.
Even at home, power sharing is needed, no?
Yes, sir.
Between father, mother, children, everybody wants power. So that power sharing is in every way. If there is another individual, only one individual is there, no need of power sharing with whom he has to share. If there are two individuals, yes. If only one individual in the world is there, he need not share the power with anybody. When you are going for a hunting, you are alone. All you are on a journey, you are alone. You need not discuss with anybody. You take a decision by yourself and do it.
Yes, sir. It's like dictatorship, sir.
No, it is not like, it means a person alone, for him no problem. If he is, if his activities are affecting another person, naturally, both should share the power. If a dictator is different, dictator is dictating on the person who is weaker. Okay? Dictator cannot dictate a term to the equal fellows, no? You are in Chinese school. Can your friends dictate to you around 10th class? You will give him bike nicely, no? One of you alone cannot do, you will join together and give him bike. So, because he cannot dictate it. But if a 12th class is there, he will dictate. That is a dictatorship. He will dictate, others will just listen. Even if more number of the students are there, complete 10th class is there, one 12th class is enough. Okay, he can control you. That is the situation. When a teacher,
yes,
in the
sir.
Class, in the class only one teacher is there. One teacher can control even 100 or 200 students, there's no problem. But the different ways it will be controlling. Teacher may be controlling not by dictatorial method. Your house captain may be controlling you by dictatorial method. There will be different way of controlling the things. Okay, that's okay. Now, question number 8. A system of checks and balances is another name for which one of the following power sharing arrangements are there. Among different social groups, is there any checks and balances? No. Vertical division of power or power shared among different levels of government, is there any checks and balances?
No, sir.
Okay.
Horizontal
division of power shared among different organs of the
government.
That is the correct answer of it. Okay. Horizontal division of power shared among different organs of the government. That is the answer. Okay. Because horizontal means
legislature, judicial.
So there is a power sharing among themselves. That is a horizontal. Okay. Now next we will go to 9th question. Which of the following features are common to Indian and Belgium from a power sharing? Power is shared among government at different levels. Power is shared among different organs of the government. Power is shared among different social groups. Power is shared among different parties and take the form of a competition. What is the correct answer? Here it is given, answer is given B. That is B, C, D. Do you agree with it?
Yes. Yes, sir. A, B, C, D. Sir, in India it is different layer letters.
Power is shared among different and government at different levels. There also they have got a local village, that language government is there. Okay. So do we have that? Power is shared among different government. So it should be same for both. Different organs of the government, it is there in both, no?
Yes. Yes, sir.
B should be common. B should be there for everybody. Okay.
Sir, C also is the social group.
C also. Power is shared among the different social groups. That is there. So, B and C should be common.
Yes.
Then, D. Power is shared among different parties and take the form of competition. No? Correct. Answer is B, C and D. Answer is B. Okay?
Sir, in Belgium... At different levels also they share it or not, sir.
Correct. Power is shared. So its answer should be A, B, C, D. A only answer, no?
Yes, yes.
Answer should be A. Okay. Correct. Then, so I have made these things to confuse you. Okay. I have not put in order the questions and answers, and I could write it down. Who had sought to put together a coherent program for unitary Italian Republic in 1830s?
Mazzini, sir.
Giuseppe Mazzini. Correct, huh?
Yes.
This is Mazzini. Who was Mazzini?
Founder of Italy, sir. revolutionary, sir.
He was a revolutionary who had started the organization named
Italian Union and
Europe. Young Italy.
Young Italy and Young Europe, sir.
Young Italy, Young Europe, Young Germany. All these organizations were started by Giuseppe Mazzini. So he had the idea of unification of Italy. Okay, correct. When Prussia took on the leadership of movement of for national unification, who was the chief architect of the movement?
Bismarck.
Otto von Bismarck, correct. Otto von Bismarck was the prime minister or chief minister of which kingdom?
Prussia.
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 Yes, he was a architect, Otto von Bismarck. His ideas were implemented. The king accepted the ideas and thinkings of Otto von Bismarck. Okay. Now, simple question is this. Next one. What is suffrage?
Right to vote.
Right to vote. Simple question. You gave the answer. Thanks. Now, which regions was the civil code exported? Dutch Republic.
Germany, sir, Switzerland, Dutch.
And the Dutch. These are the areas where Napoleon Bonaparte has taken the idea of Napoleonic code. Dutch Republic. What is the modern name of Dutch? Huh? Anybody?
Portuguese.
Portugal is another name, another country. Dutch has got another name.
Czech Republic.
Czech Republic is there. That's all, same. No change. Now also Dutch. The people are called Dutch. But the country's name is something else. This is a small country. They were ruling in Vietnam and all those areas. In Europe.
Holland, sir.
Huh?
Denmark, sir.
No.
Holland, sir. Holland.
No.
Netherlands.
Yes. This is Netherlands. Netherlands, the people of Netherlands are called Dutch. Okay. We don't call them Netherlands people. We call them Dutch.
Dutch.
So, Netherlands and Dutch both are same. Clear? So, if you hear anywhere Netherlands, Dutch, don't get confused. Okay? The people of Netherlands. Pardon?
Dutch is a language, sir.
Dutch, the people are called. Dutch is a language also. Dutch language is there. And the people are called Dutch people.
Yes.
Okay. As English people we call England, no? Same way, Dutch people. Dutch people, but the country's name is Netherlands. English people we call, but their name is really Britain, no? Great Britain.
Yes, sir.
We use sometimes British. That's only. The same way, the people of Netherlands are called Dutch. Okay. So, simple thing was it is. Then Napoleon destroyed the institution or a system that existed in
democracy.
Yes.
14th, I think you have looked.
Okay, we'll come back to that 14th. Okay. 15th. Napoleon had destroyed democracy in France. Really, there was a revolution in 1789 for democracy. That democracy was destroyed by Napoleon. Okay. He started a monarchy really. But he could not continue for long time, only less time. But he was ruling like a monarch. He was never ruling like a elected king. Okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll go back to 14th question. Which countries did the French armies move into? Because Napoleon led the armies to different part of Europe and they were welcomed by those countries because they were considered as harbingers of a democracy. Harbinger is a bird which brings good music. So they democrat the this one, what is it? Germany, oh sorry, French ideals and thinkings were welcomed by the people. So answer is Holland, Belgium, Switzerland and some part of
Italy.
Okay, Holland, Netherlands, Holland and Netherlands both, Dutch, all are called the same, okay? Holland has got another, Holland and Dutch is same. Again, don't get confused, okay? Did you understand what I am saying? Holland, Dutch, Netherlands, all the three names are for the one country. Okay?
Yes.
Don't get confused. Dutch, Holland and Netherlands, both are same. Like Great Britain, England, United Kingdom, same way it is. Netherlands, Dutch, Holland, etc. Then, when did the Treaty of Vienna took place? Who were the participants?
2015.
The answer is very clearly given
Britain,
there.
Britain, Russia.
But Russia, Russia was there. It was not a prominent figure.
Yes.
What was their main plan of the agreement?
To bring monarch back. Integration.
Integration. Is it integration? They had a common enemy. Who was their common enemy?
Napoleon. Napoleon, sir.
Yes. So they had the common enemy. Main aim of them was to defeat their common enemy named
Napoleon.
That is it. Okay, Napoleon was there. Okay, so 1815, Britain, Russia, Prussia and Austria. They gathered it together at what place? Which place?
Versailles.
It is written there in the question itself. Vienna. They met at Vienna.
Vienna.
Vienna is the capital of which country?
Austria, sir.
Austria. Okay. They met at Vienna. And who was the Chancellor of Austria?
Duke Metternich, sir.
Duke Metternich. There is a famous statement made by him.
If France needs
When France sneezes, entire Europe gets cold. There is a famous statement made by Duke Metternich, the Chancellor of Austria. He was the architect of Vienna Conference and the Treaty of Vienna in 1815. The main plan was to defeat Napoleon and bring back the systems that established or that existed prior to a revolution in France. Everything should go back. That was the thinking of the people or leaders who had gathered at Vienna in 1815. Okay. Then, what type of rule was carried out in France during Napoleon's time? Was it a federal rule, democracy, monarchy, republic?
Monarchy.
What is the difference between republic and monarchy?
Republic is freedom, sir. Monarchy is ruled by a king.
Republic?
Freedom, sir. No one, people, to the people and to the people.
There is a democracy. No, what is a republic?
Republic. Controlling the people's hands, sir.
No. France is a republic. Britain is not a republic. India is a republic. Japan is not a republic. America is a republic. Then which country? Netherlands is not a republic.
China is a republic.
China is a republic.
People represent
the
where the election takes place.
There is election in Britain also. There is a prime minister is elected. Japan also prime minister is elected.
Rules and regulations are written.
Japan is not called a republic. Britain is not called a republic, but India is called a republic.
Because their kings and queen are there, sir.
So what is it called? The king. The symbol meaning.
King will change, sir.
The symbol meaning, listen, is the head of the country is elected. It is called a republic. Okay? Clear?
Yes.
Head of the country is elected. It is called a republic. In America, president is elected. Okay? In India, yes. The president is elected.
Yes.
In France also president is elected. In China also president is elected. So all these are called republics. In Japan, the king is not elected. It's a hereditary post. In Britain, the king is not elected. It is a hereditary post.
Sir, what is hereditary post?
Means father to son or to daughter, whoever is their successor. They will get the kingship.
Sir, if they don't have father...
They can adopt. They can adopt. Father is not having a son or a daughter, they can adopt. Okay?
Like Mysore, sir.
Mysore, they have adopted. But Mysore has no power. Only that property they have got right. That's adoption. Okay, the king, yes. That is a king. There is no election to the post of the head of the country in those countries. That is in Japan, in Britain, and in Netherlands. Okay, or Dutch. The kings, there are kings in those countries. They are the heads of the countries.
Sir, in Mysore, still king is there, sir.
But king has no authority on anything, no? He cannot control the people, no power on the people. Only his wealth and that he has got. Only his property. He has got his land and property. And the government gives him as a recognition that Mysore Palace, during the Dasara season, he is given some permission to come out into that function. That's only. He has no power over the people. Okay? And he cannot control the government.
Sir, in constitution it is written, sir, he gets financial support by government, sir.
There was in the time when the kingdoms were given.
Yes.
It is known as privy purse.
Yes, sir.
The kings, when they surrendered their land, their kingdom to Indian Union, they were offered some money. It was for 10 years or 15 years old. After that they are stopped. Government, now the government is not giving any money to the kings. Okay. No money is given. Mysore king gets the permission only for during the festival time, Dasara time, he is permitted to be part of it. But the property, income, asset of Mysore Palace is of the government. It is not of the king. Understand? Mysore Palace
is
not
property of king, sir.
We will have his land and all those things, some agriculture land on so much areas of land on some other palace where they were residing was given to him. The main important palace is taken over by the government.
Sir, it is like they are just continuing trying to sell all
the trust. They don't know, but they cannot collect the taxes from the people, no? People are not giving tax to the king of Mysore.
Okay.
People give tax to the government of India or state government or Bille Panchayat. No tax is paid by the king. If anybody is not paying, if anybody gives free something to the king, that's different. And if anybody is not giving free, king cannot arrest that person. Earlier, king could arrest that person and put him in jail. Now, that is not possible. That is the thing. Okay? Understood? So, the head of the country means elected is called a republic. Okay?